These days, robots are more connected to our lives than ever before. They are evolving to become more like us. Only on 5 Tonight, Betty Yu takes us inside a Bay Area facility churning out these social robots.
Hi, my name is Pepper. How can I help you today?
Pepper is 4 feet tall, friendly, and full of personality. It's got rhythm, too. Pepper is a social robot. A new generation of bots that's more human than ever.
Pepper, can you tell me a story?
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
Powered by SoftBank Robotics, Pepper can be programmed to act like a concierge or just be your friend.
Here, take my hand.
It's one of many that can be found walking around the innovation lab at Singularity University, a think tank at Moffett Field's NASA Research Park. Soon, these kinds of bots may walk right into our everyday lives.
I want to show the more cooperative side of robots. So I really like demonstrating how these robots are making an impact in people's lives.
Matthew Abisu is known as the robot wrangler on campus. He helps build and program prototypes and teaches entrepreneurs about social robots. His goal is to deconstruct the stereotype of robots as threatening machines and bring the romanticized sci-fi images in movies closer to home. Robotics is one of the hottest new markets in tech. After growing at a rate of 17% each year, analysts predict the robot market will be worth $135 billion by 2019. We already find artificial intelligence on our smartphones or in appliances like Amazon's Alexa.
So instead of replacing humans, they're going to be working alongside them to help augment the workflow.
Hand me something, please.
There are already 20,000 Peppers and now robots like this one at work in the world, mostly in Japan, being used to teach students how to program, working in businesses and hospitals, and living with families. Now can even do Tai Chi.
It's got good robot form.
Monique Gigi runs startup programs at Singularity University, a product that recently came out of its incubator.
I'm looking for hammers.
The Lobot, which roams the aisles at Bay Area Lowe's home improvement stores. It acts as an employee's assistant. The machines can handle boring yet important tasks like inventory tracking, freeing up employees to help customers.
If a robot or a robot empowered with artificial intelligence could take care of that for you in a subtle way, in a non-intrusive way, that's, you know, it enables us to be human. It enables us to do the things that we love to do the most.
Humans are literally getting more connected to these bots. Matthew programmed these toy robots to react to brainwave activity, which is tracked by the headset. The more relaxed he's feeling, the slower the movement. When he's extremely focused, they march forward.
Design strategies that reduce data resolution.
I gave it a shot and read this scientific book, which sent the bots moving in circles, signaling confusion.
We're going to see a lot of new types of robots coming out in the market this year especially. We want to be able to work with them and understand them in the same way that I could work with a coworker and understand them.
At Moffett Field, Betty Yu, KPIX 5.